r/ascredit, what only exists because people are stupid. When my aunt died, I ended up with my mom and uncle talking to the funeral home advisor. When they were discussing cremation, the funeral advisor made my uncle sign a form that he understands cremation is irreversible. Stickers on wood chippers telling people not to stick their limbs inside. Warnings on microwaves and ovens that the food might be hot afterwards. That is pretty much the purpose of those, to heat the food. There's a nice little sign above the shredder where I work warning people that documents put through this device will not be recoverable. The commercials where they do some things that are nearly impossible for a regular human to do, but they still have to say, "Do not try this at home, because someone is definitely going to try." That warning at the end of every pharmaceutical ad. Don't take Rippersetol if you are allergic to Rippersetol. One time a very religious exchange student from Sierra Leone asked me where he could get dong enlargement pills in America. Even after I told him they're a scam, he said he still wanted them so girls would like him. So then I told him he doesn't want to be with the kind of women who would only like him for the size of his dong. Then he smiled and said, "I like that. I got you, buddy, be happy with who you are." On every candy bar wrapper, there are instructions that you should put it into the trash. Stupid is probably going a bit far, but there are plenty of products that were massively unpopular because they worked too well and people just didn't get them. The best example I can think of is Febreze, which was designed as a scent eradicator and was, by its very nature, completely odorless. The only problem is that people get used to their own personal brand of stank, so they couldn't tell the difference between their own smelly home before and after it was sprayed. Recently started a job that has a massive walk-in freezer. Part of the induction was explaining that you shouldn't lick the frozen metal rollers that the stock was placed on. My reply: "We can still lick the regular ones though, right? Totally wrong crowd, ha ha." Diseases that have long been eradicated that are coming back because of the idiots who don't vaccinate their kids. Signs at the supermarkets telling people not to wash their hands in the fish tanks or the tanks of any other sea creatures. This should be an unspoken rule, but because it was unspoken, someone definitely decided to wash their hands in the tanks. I go to several anime and video game conventions, and I sometimes see very specific rules that make me laugh because I know there was some incident and they made a rule about it. Stuff like: no wearing roller skates while you're also wearing a leash. Costumes may not be on fire. Do not release birds inside the building. Do not try to build a trampoline. Abstinence-only sex education. Look, you can argue the merits or demerits of religion all you want, but anyone who looks at the problem of teen pregnancy and says let's take rooms full of people who've just become the horniest they're ever likely to be in their entire lives and try and scare them out of ducking each other is an idiot, and everyone who allocates funds to it is even worse. Internet scams. Tons of idiots out there. It crosses all genders, ages, races and education level. But man, if people aren't dumb as a box of rocks. Way too many Redditors even come to r/scams asking about scams they either fell for or are about to. It's sad, really. I can't imagine how one could ever send a stranger money sight unseen. I don't even part with money to people I know. Can't imagine giving even a penny to strangers. So in France, soy milks and any other milks in that kind are now labeled vegetal beverages because it was too confusing. Guess people thought you have to milk soybeans like a cow. I'm gonna also put that there is vegetal chicken, which is basically chicken raised with vegetables, I think, and no one raised an eyebrow on that one. Betty Crocker once made a cake mix that was add water only. No need for other ingredients. And it came out the most perfect, moist cake. People stopped buying it because adding water didn't make them feel like they were baking a cake. Betty Crocker took away ingredients and needed people to add milk and eggs to the mix so people will buy their cake mix again. Plug outlet covers. Yeah, I'm talking about those plastic lumps. They exist, at least ostensibly, to stop babies from sticking their fingers and toys into plug sockets and electrocuting themselves. Is she saying that babies are dumb for trying to play with plug sockets? I hear you ask. They're just babies. Well, yes, babies will do just about anything they can to self-destruct in the most dangerous ways possible if you leave them alone for even a minute. But the real issue is that the plug guards are more dangerous than the exposed plugs. Plug sockets in the UK are ridiculously well designed, and have security feature to stop exactly that from happening. Most importantly, the bottom two holes, the only ones with current flowing through them, have plastic guards that open up only when the top hole is probed. The top prong on a British plug is longer than the others for this exact reason. But surely it doesn't do any harm? After all, they're just plastic. The only problem is, they come in unstandardized sizes, so people often use ones that don't actually fit, and even if they do, the odds of your kid accidentally opening up the sockets by putting the guard in wrong is much bigger if you have something right there that fits the bill. After all, it's not like we constantly train babies to put certain shaped things in the appropriately shaped holes. That's the purpose of every second baby toy on the market. Diamond rings for proposal and marriage. We somehow believe that shiny rocks are a good measure of our love for another person, and that lie fuels an entire industry. Surgeon General warnings. Yeah, smoking cigs and drinking scotch aren't good for a baby. This isn't Mad Men. Detailed signs in some fast food restaurants instructing people on how to wash their hands. This is something you should have learned at age 3 or so. I had to call Optimum Internet last night because of an outage. The automated system instructed me to unplug my modem what 10 seconds and plug it back in, then wait several minutes for it to reboot. Problem is, I had just done that before I called. You know, like an intelligent person should do. But the system was built with only stupid people in mind, and when I pushed the button to skip to the next step, it said that I had to wait till it was fully loaded. There was no way around it. I had to wait because they assumed no one would call after they had already done that. Super upsetting. I had a keyboard fail on a Dell laptop while under warranty. I had the home service policy, so I called Dell to get them to send a tech to replace the keyboard. I got a real human tech on the phone, and they told me to restart the computer and press F5, or some other F key, I forget, when I saw the Dell splash page. Didn't you hear me say that the keyboard doesn't work? Well, yes, he heard me, but he still had a long checklist he had to go through first. All of the steps required me to push a key on the broken and totally unresponsive keyboard. 30 minutes later, the tech agrees that the keyboard is broken and sends me a new one via overnight delivery. A tech showed up the next day to fix it. I was invited to one of these meetings about 20 years ago. The showcased person was an MD who'd walked away from his practice because he had discovered Amway and worked his way up to double diamond. Naturally, he was now living in a mansion and grossing far more than he had ever imagined making as a physician. The most curious thing about the meeting was the prominent table covered with motivational tapes and DVDs, which were all fairly expensive. Later, I discovered that these materials are how a lot of the upline makes much of their profits. I was initially interested but did some research on the internet, which fortunately had enough info at the time to tell me what a scam it is, and quickly lost interest. This was underscored by the fact that a couple of my friends at the time, who had far less than medical degrees, kept their day jobs despite having a fairly immersive involvement in Amway. Like a lot of people with Amway friends do, I bought a few items from them to make them happy, but I wasn't overly impressed with Amway products or pricing. Got a new hairdryer recently. Promise you this, the box said instructions for use, do not use while sleeping. Damn. There goes my Friday plans. I have a jar of mixed nuts on my desk. It says, I kid you not, warning, may contain nuts. That Tide Pod Challenge. Thank you for watching Reddit Central. Make sure to subscribe and ring the notification bell so you never miss any new videos. Feel free to share any similar stories in the comments below.